Hi there and welcome to the second video. In this video, you're going to see how to use Ansible to install HestiaCP. In the last video, you saw how to do a Debian 12 initial server setup with Ansible. If you didn't watch that, go back and watch it. So first thing, download and extract the files from there. And once you download and extract the file, you're going to see this is what you have in there. Ansiblecfg, these are things I spoke about in the last video. Inventory, add your IP inventory there. Playbook, Debian, this is for doing the initial server setup. And in this part, I'm going to uncomment the part for installing HestiaCP. So this HestiaCP installation is based on this role. This role is found in the Ansible Galaxy. And we're going to look at this, how to edit. We're going to edit various things like the host's name and any other thing that we need to edit. So this role is already edited. The one I've included here is already edited and it works with the current HestiaCP version because the role is slightly outdated, just slightly, not too outdated. It's still very helpful in installing HestiaCP. So thanks to the original creator. So let's look at this role. So the role I will be basing this installation off of is available in the Ansible Galaxy role search HestiaCP. All right, so if you search, you'll see that there's one role in the HestiaCP Galaxy, and this role lets you install HestiaCP. My installation is based on this. If I do an ls inside of the roles directory, you'll see we have the role in there. So the thing that I need to edit, or rather the things that you're going to need to edit, let's look at them. So vi roles and HestiaCP tab, not HestiaCP, but I can just press tab to autocomplete, and under defaults, let's look at what we need to edit inside here. So the server host name, I just leave it as that. That's the one that I've put there as a sample for you, and you should edit it. So all the other items here, if you wanted to place this in an Ansible vault, that is the admin mail, password, username. In the last video, I did an example whereby I put the username and the password in a vault. So if you want to put this in a vault, you can do so. You can also just edit here, enter your email. Here as well, you can enter a password. So this is a password you're going to use to log in as the admin user. And then HestiaCP admin username, this was added. This is a feature that was added recently in HestiaCP, allowing you to change the admin username. So that's what I've added there. The admin username, you can change it and make it whatever you want. I'm going to leave that as it is. And then HestiaCP install flags. So if you want to install Apache, of course, change this to yes. If you want to install PHP FPM, yes. Multi PHP, you can see this was also something that I had to add here, because multi PHP now allows you to select the PHP versions that you want to install. So if you want to install PHP 7.4, you can add PHP 7.4 here and all the PHP versions that you need. So make sure you edit that. And then if you want to install VSFTP, then you can install it. If you want to install Pro FTP, you can install that. If you want to install named MySQL as well, if you want to install MySQL, you can install MySQL. And then Postgres, you can install Postgres. Exim, if you don't want any item, just type yes or no, right? No or yes. If you have a small server, of course, you want to leave that uninstalled. And then as well, port, if you want to change the port, let's change the port to 2083, just for demo's sake, just for demonstration. So I'll change the Hestia port to 2083. This is something that I believe I had to uncheck because it is null and void, considering I've already set up multi-PHP up there. So I had to uncheck this. Anything else that we need here? HestiaCP generate SSL, you can generate it or not. If you already have your DNS pointed to your host name, and that is a server host name that is up at the top of this file, then you can change this to yes, and Hestia is going to generate an SSL certificate for that domain. I'm just going to leave this as it is. Escape, Shift, ZZ. Let's go to the playbook that I used in the last video. And this is a playbook that helps you set up Debian. The one thing that I had commented out was the HestiaCP installation. So I'm just going to uninstall the, I'm just going to uncomment this so that HestiaCP can also be installed. So install HestiaCP, and it's going to go into this roles. It's going to use this role. That is pretty much it. Then I will escape, Shift ZZ to save. I will run the playbook again, Ansible. So let me just search for it, Control R, playbook, Control R. There we go. Ensure you've edited your inventory file to add your server host name, to add your server IP. For this demonstration, I'll use the same server I used in the last video. If you're new to Valtra and you're going to use it, you can find the link with the $300 credit in the description. So let's just run that. And this might take a while, so I'll pause, and then once we need to do anything, I'm going to resume recording. So as I was waiting for it to complete, I just noticed that I still have UFW enabled, and UFW has added various ports. UFW has allowed various ports. If you're going to install HestiaCP, just uncomment out that part, or you can go into the playbook and disable UFW. Where it says enabled, just disable it. So for some reason, it's hanging here. I don't know what the issue is. I wish I had run the playbook with -vv for verbosity, but I didn't. So let's just see if it's installed. Because if I look at the server, Control L, if I do htop, okay, I can see PHP has been installed. PHP is running. So HestiaCP is probably running and also installed. Let's just confirm. Control Shift, Control V for the IP. I'll paste the IP, and the port, we set the port as 2083. So let's go in. Oh, what did I do? Okay, I'll just copy this. I'll just edit this here. Copy, paste and go. And you can see we can access Hestia. All right, so let's try and log in. And you remember where the user and password was. So let's come back. It was under defaults. Here, I'll just open this. The admin username was admin copy, enter. The password was this, copy, Control V, enter. There we go, Hestia is installed. Let's just confirm that all services are running. So if I come back here and I look at it, you'll see that all the services we sought out to install are all here. All right, there we go. WordPress is installed and working. You can install and update plugins, no problem. Say you wanted to enable, FCGI. You can come in here and enable FCGI. If you wanted to use PHP 8.4, you can do so here as well. Save. That's how to install HestiaCP via Ansible. We've installed it and seen it working. And at this point, I'm going to end the video. So you can download this. It includes initial server setup plus HestiaCP installation. That is on this page. If I forget to add it, just remind me. Sometimes I forget. See you next time.